Are you wondering what other medications are safe to take during pregnancy? Well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you some over-the-counter medications, part two, that are safe to take during pregnancy. So stay tuned. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Josephine and I'm a registered nurse. And here on this channel, we talk about the journey to pregnancy for new moms, motherhood, and inspiration. If you are new, consider subscribing if any of those interest you. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. So glad that you are here. Let's get into the content for today. Okay, so we're gonna be going over part two of our medication series that are safe and effective to take while pregnant. If you haven't seen the first part of the series, definitely make sure you watch here because those are the medications that are more common and those are the symptoms that most women get during pregnancy that I cover. And all the medications that we talk about today will be in the description box below, so check out those links. So we're gonna be talking about hemorrhoids. Yeah, the good fun hemorrhoids. Yeah, we're gonna be talking about the roids. So what is hemorrhoids? So hemorrhoids are just veins inside or outside of the body that get swollen and pretty much just enlarged. And they usually develop later in pregnancy, but it is also common to develop it early in pregnancy because as you are growing a baby, your uterus gets bigger, you start to produce more blood, and to compensate for that, your body starts to actually increase the size of your veins. So with all the pressure that's going down on your abdominal wall or lower towards your rectum, more likely that you will get hemorrhoids. And that just, all that pressure just pushes down on the veins that are down there, on the muscles that are down there, and a lot of times it makes them protrude outside of your body or move in a way inside your body that you're not used to. So symptoms of hemorrhoids is bleeding when you have a bowel movement or when you wipe, you see some blood there. You'll have pain associated when you go to the bathroom. You may even have itching and burning, and you'll feel a protrusion near your anus. So some medications that are used for hemorrhoids are Preparation H cream, and Preparation H also has some wipes that have witch hazel in it. Witch hazel is great for soothing irritated places or areas. And so you can wipe with the wipes and then you could put and apply the cream on to prevent any future irritation. You can also try suppositories such as Anusol HC. That is really popular because it has an anesthetic medication aspect to it, meaning that it has some pain relieving properties when you put it in, so you'll get fast relief. A suppository, if you don't know what it is where you have to stick the medication up your hoo-ha or butthole. So next we're gonna be talking about gas and bloating. Now with pregnancy comes the increased amount of progesterone that your body will be producing. And what progesterone does to the body is it actually makes the smooth muscle in your gastrointestinal tract relaxed. And what that does is it gives you constipation, it gives you more gas, and it could lead to bloating as well. So some medications that you can take to combat this are simethicone or Gasex, whichever generic brand that you have at your pharmacy, and Phazon. Now, if you start to develop some type of cough, whether you got the flu, whether you just got the common cold, or you're just having a coughing fit that you're not too sure where it's coming from, you can take Robitussin and Mucinex over the counter for specifically cough. Okay, our next topic is going to be diarrhea. Now, diarrhea isn't as common as constipation during pregnancy, but what can happen is if you change your prenatals or start taking new prenatals that can cause diarrhea, if you start changing your diet to include more fiber nutrient diets, or you're just starting to eat healthier, that can also give you diarrhea. The medication of choice for diarrhea is Imodium AD. Now, if you continually have diarrhea for a couple of days, you need to talk to your healthcare provider to make sure that you don't get dehydrated and no electrolytes are out of balance. Next, we're going to be talking about yeast infections. Now, yeast infections are pretty common during pregnancy because you have hormonal changes happening, which causes your pH levels in your vaginal canal to change. And so a lot of times when your pH changes, you have microorganisms that just thrive on lower or higher pH. So don't be alarmed if you have a yeast infection. Some common medications that you can take are Monistat 7. Now I do wanna say, as a registered nurse, it is always best practice to talk to your healthcare provider about what medications are safe and effective to take. Now all of these have been proven by studies that are safe and effective during pregnancy. But if you are taking any of these medications in excess, you definitely want to make sure that you're communicating with your OB-GYN doctor or healthcare provider. And if you have any questions that you'd like to leave in the comments below, I'd be happy to answer them. If you found this video helpful at all, definitely give it a thumbs up. And if you are new, consider subscribing to the channel and join our tribe of women encouraging and supporting one another. I always say here on the channel, it's always a great day to grow in life. Grow your baby, grow emotionally, and grow spiritually. I will see you guys later. Love you guys. Bye.